What do you think about a credit agency, a municipal credit agency, to create the capital funds that the city needs?
We have one. Municipal Finance Authority is probably one of the best borrowing agencies anywhere in North America. It's being duplicated and copied in other provinces, in states, in the U.S., and other countries. The Municipal Finance Authority gives us money at the lowest possible rate. We are borrowing at a better rate than often provincial or federal governments can borrow at, because the municipalities all have balanced budgets. We're so careful with our money. Our credit rating is superior. We have AAA credit ratings. So we're able to borrow money at the cheapest possible rate. That's one of the problems with privatization, with these so-called 3Ps, is that the private sector can't borrow anywhere close to the rates that municipalities borrow. They're 2 or 3% higher. So when the private sector borrows that money, you're automatically paying 2 or 3% more than you would pay if you borrowed through the municipalities.
How is it run? Is that a branch of the provincial government, or is it a non-profit organization?
It's a non-profit organization organized by the municipalities.
Right. And where do they get the money?
Borrow on the open market. Much of the money comes in from pension funds, you know, who are looking at absolutely safe investments. So you have an opportunity to be able to place your money in the Rock of Gibraltar, which is in essence the guarantees of all the municipalities. Now, Burnaby doesn't have any debt. We don't owe any money. We're on the positive side. So we have around $400 million in reserves, but we have no debt.
We can borrow from you.
Exactly. So we're a positive guarantor on the Municipal Finance Authority. So when someone comes in to borrow money, if you've got a small town in northern British Columbia, they're going to get the same interest rate on borrow that money as we would.
What interest because rate we're, is it? How much is it now?
Oh, the rate is that we're borrowing at prime or below prime.
Which is what?
Oh.
4.5%.
Okay. You know, so we're borrowing at very favorable rates. And small towns that could never borrow at those rates are able to do it because big cities like Burnaby are part of the overall Municipal Finance Authority. And so we're the muscle that allows the borrowing rates to remain very, very low, even though we don't utilize that borrowing power. We only borrow internally.
Have you ever heard of the Canadian Action Party, which Paul Hillier started a few years ago, and he ran a couple of federal elections? And his complaint is that the Bank of Canada should be creating all the money to lend to provincial governments and municipalities. Have you looked into it?
I haven't. Is it? I think that obviously Paul Hillier would have a lot of information about those issues. I mean, he was a former finance minister. He's
defense minister.
Yeah, I think he was a finance minister at one point, wasn't he?
But maybe as well.
He certainly was a minister of the federal government, and I think he has a lot of experience in those areas. Yeah. You know, I don't, to be honest with you, is that at the level of Bank of Canada finance, I don't have a lot of experience. Mm-hmm. I do know that if we can work as effectively a cooperative, and that's really what happens with the Municipal Finance Authority, we're working as a cooperative of municipalities to increase our ability to borrow money at a lower rate by coming together, just like co-ops do for other people in different industries, is that we're able to come together and get the best benefit for all of our members by us working cooperatively. There is a real reason, you know, in the public interest for us to work cooperatively, because every time we save a point is we're saving millions of dollars of public money that can go into other useful purposes. So, you know, I have no hesitation in being part of the Municipal Finance Authority, even though we're not utilizing it, is no hesitation in being a part of that, because it's for the good of British Columbia. It's for the good of each and every city in British Columbia, and for every citizen, that we're borrowing at the lowest possible rate.
Mm-hmm. We talked a little bit about housing the last time we were here, and obviously you said that's not a municipal responsibility. However, there are some cities that have some social housing, and I wonder if you have homeless people in Burnaby, and what would the municipality be able to do about it?
Well, we have the second highest amount of social housing in Burnaby in the Lower Mainland, in the province.
That means how many units?
Well, thousands. Thousands of units. Is that we have the second highest number of units. We're behind only Vancouver. Mm-hmm. And we have more units than Surrey does, more social housing units. Mm-hmm. So we have been a municipality that's exercised a great amount of leadership in social housing over many, many decades.
And that subsidy means giving yearly grants to societies or whoever is managing the buildings?
No, is that we work through the GVRD, obviously, through Metro Vancouver, which has a portfolio of housing. So Metro Vancouver carries thousands of units itself. Some of those units are here in Burnaby or in Vancouver or in Richmond, but they're subsidized units. Some are at market rent, some are subsidized units. Mm-hmm. We have been big supporters of cooperatives, which are one of the most effective ways to have subsidized units and mixed opportunities.
But they are provincial, housing. The cooperatives are provincial projects, and they still receive some subsidy from the provincial government.
The federal government was mainly for the cooperatives, and they provided through CMHC reduced interest rates and guarantees.
That's right.
You know, the reality is that municipalities, I've told you before, get 8 cents out of every dollar. Mm-hmm. The only place we have to draw money is from property taxes.
But you're doing very well. You said you have $400 million in reserves.
Exactly.
So with the 8 cents, you're doing very well.
Yes.
And besides, you have land. You have a lot of, you own some land.
We invest in land, and we transfer land for development. We're always looking to be able to ensure that our community can develop the way we want it to develop. And so holding land's a major portion of our responsibilities. The provincial and federal government want desperately to get out of the business of housing and to download housing onto municipalities. And they've been trying to do that for a number of years. You've got to remember, the Liberals 20 years ago got out of doing any kind of housing. They killed the cooperative movement. They made CMHC ineffective. They built massive reserves. Both the provincial and federal government have massive reserves. As I've told you, they can spend $900 million on a convention center but spend nothing on affordable housing. They won't even move to tax benefits so that we can increase the amount of rental housing. Now, in our city, what we have done, and last night, in fact, we just passed a motion, is that in our town centers where we're able to get higher density, we've been looking to provide additional bonus density in return for contributions to a housing fund. So by the builders. So the new development that's occurring, our account is probably up to around $8 million now, and 20% of that is donated. Is considered to be money that's put into housing. And what we want to do is not to buy housing. We are not the people who build housing. What we want to do is we want to stimulate nonprofit groups or other organizations in getting that kind of.
How do you stimulate those nonprofit groups?
By contributing monies to it, to waive fees for development cost charges or licensing or inspections to be able to make it more affordable for them to be able to do these things in our community. But I do this with a great reluctance and a great resentment because the provincial government and federal government are the ones who are responsible for housing. The thing is, we're the easiest ones to talk to. We're the people that are there every week holding a public meeting. Try and get in to see a minister. Try to get in to see someone from the federal government about these issues. Money for homelessness that the federal government designated for homeless was transferred to the provincial government, to the government of British Columbia, who instead of putting it into homelessness, put it into health care.
Yeah.
So we've seen that over and over again. The reality is that this provincial government really believes that people who are homeless deserve it. And the only way that they're going to get out of it is for them to show remorse and ask for redemption. This government believes, and they've said, the MLAs locally have said to me, we don't believe in the professionalization of caring. What they want is they want you to go to a flop house, and they want you preferably to accept Jesus. Mm-hmm. They want you to be in a situation where you are going to do what you need to do in order to get services from a charity. They want volunteers to do it.
Mr. Corrigan, we have a polling site And I'd like to encourage you to go to ourpolls.ca.
Ourpolls.ca.
We also call it nowpolling.ca. And it's just a list of questions on housing, on TransLink. And if you like some of those questions, please register and vote. And let us know if you have some topics that we should add there that are of the interest to municipalities. So thank you very much for your time.
Thank you. I've really enjoyed it. It's a pleasure.
Have a good year.
Thank you.
All right. All right.
I enjoy it. It's that these are the important issues that we're facing out there in the world. And,
I know.
And they're intense issues. They're ones that are critical.
But you know what I still miss is the solution. And I hear from you saying we're doomed, we're toast, and I wish you know you could say here is a solution. Let's have a revolution. I don't mean an armed revolution with weapons and like in Nicaragua or in Venezuela, but
it's going to come to that.
An ideal revolution where people say let's make this recall system work.